Very rainy morning to all of you today. It has been raining heavily since morning time. So good weather. So let's enjoy this rainy weather by learning. Very interesting chapter it is. Very humorous. You will be laughing out today because you're going to read very humorous incident in this. So before I start, again, we have already started. We have read a page or two, but those who were not there yesterday, let me tell for them again. This chapter, I have today written themes. Yesterday, I have written some, incidents of plots and all. I have written the theme. So you need to take notes of whatever I have written on the board. Clear? It's a humorous narrative. The story is humorous. It is funny. Fine? Why it is funny? Because we would be reading how a homeopathic doctor would be narrating his experience of meeting a snake, how he would be running after it, or whether he would be able to save his life or not. Obviously, he has saved his life. That's why he's narrating story. But how he would be saving his life, that is to be seen. Then we would be reading about the funny thoughts which come to the mind of this doctor. Fine? Yesterday I told you he's self-obsessed. He thinks about himself that I'm a bachelor and I am a doctor. On the top of that, I am handsome, and how I can look more handsome by looking in the mirror. Fine? And then firstly, the theme of human vanity and fears. Very important. We would be learning from this chapter that how we people waste our time in, human vanity. Sorry. What is human vanity and fears? We, waste a lot of money on looking good. One should look good. One should be presentable. But one should not, one should not be self-obsessed about oneself only. There are a lot of things in life which you need to look up to. Your family, your friends, your social circle and all. It's not only about you. But this doctor, this homeopathic doctor, he's so self-obsessed that he thinks that he's a bachelor, and on the top of that, he's a doctor. So he's boasting about his profession. So this is a theme of human vanity. Fine? And fears. Now, second part is fears. What sort of fears? When he saw a snake, when sudden situations come in front of us, how we react to it, that is another theme. Clear? Theme of fear. Then, theme of how crisis make people turn to God for help. Otherwise, when our exams are there, then we will be standing in front of the mandir and, ringing the bell and, oh God, please, I would be offering you prasad. Please do something for me. Fine. Otherwise, when casual days are going on, we would be listening to music, we would be dancing, we would be eating out at restaurants. We won't even listen, we won't even pray to God. We forget this thing. When somebody is not well at home, we keep praying to God, oh God, please save myself, save me, save my mother, save my brother, father and all. So otherwise, when our life is going smoothly, we do not remember even God. So this is another theme, that how crisis make people turn to God for help. When there is situation, then we turn ourselves toward, then we become spiritual, we become very religious, start offering prayers to God. So this is another theme. When this doctor, otherwise doctors believe that we are the ones who are serving to society, and when he would be encountering a snake in front of him, then he would be remembering God. This is another theme. Clear? So all the themes are clear. Send me thumbs up quickly. Very good. Jia, Gagan, Riyanshika, Aryan, Divya, Titiksha. Okay, I'm just speaking names. Those who are quick learners and sending me quick thumbs up. So now I would be sharing the screen. If we will be able to finish this chapter today, I would be showing you a video also. That is quite interesting for you. Okay, if. So screen is clear to all of you. Encourage your friends to join on daily basis. Okay, I already told you. I keep on sending messages in the group, but sometimes friends listen to their friends only. So there are 31 students, including me, 32. So ask your friends, encourage them that they should come on daily basis. This is online class. When you will learn, watching videos later on, that is not a, you can say, big thing. Interact with the teacher. So we have read this page already. You know, this is the gable and rats are there. Homeopathic doctor is, this is a story within a story. Those who were not there, let me give you a brief introduction. The story within a story, or a narrative within a narrative, in which a homeopathic doctor is narrating his experience with the author of the story. So a group of friends are sitting together and sharing their experiences. And their homeopathic doctor started by asking, have you heard about a snake story? I would be telling you. So he started narrating his experience with the snake. And everybody started listening to him patiently. Fine. And then he tells that as when he was a practicing physician, how he was, having meager earnings. He was having a rented room. There were few objects in his room. That is a table, a lamp, a mirror, a comb, books, and few clothing. Only one black coat he was having with him, which he was wearing already. Then the room was not electrified. There was no electricity. He was having 60 rupees in his suitcase, some shirts and dhotis, and one black coat. Fine. What does it show? That he was a poor chap at that time, poor man at that time. Clear? So when he was back, after having a meal in the restaurant, he went back to his rented room to sleep, but he was not able to sleep. There were rats in his room. They were making continuous noise. And then he started reading a book named Materia Magica, sitting on a chair in front of a mirror. And suddenly his eyes fell upon the mirror and he started appreciating his own personality. Fine? Now we would be reading from page number 57. And he, after looking in the mirror, he says, I'm a bachelor, I'm handsome, and on the top of that, I'm a doctor. So he is self-obsessed that I should, be more presentable, how I can look more handsome. I would grow a thin mustache. Paragraph number 6, I would be reading now, fine? I got up, paced up and down the room. Then another lovely thought struck me. I would marry. Now I told you that this is very humorous. You will be laughing up top, listening to the thoughts of this doctor. He says that after I could not read the book, I again got up and I started walking. Then a thought came to my mind. What was that thought? That I would marry. He should get married. And I would get married to a woman doctor. First condition is the woman should be a doctor. Second, and who had plenty of money. Second condition, what he's thinking, that she should be rich and a good medical practice. She should have good experience. Third demand of this homeopathic doctor, who is already a poor chap, fine? She had to be fat for a valid reason. Now, this is quite funny. This is quite humorous. People, they whenever they want to get married, they just want a thin match, a suitable, tall. You just read in the newspaper, a tall, thin match required for a doctor and all. Such kind of ads are there, advertisements are there in the newspaper. But this homeopathic doctor, he wants a fat woman. Why? For a valid reason. If I made some silly mistake and needed to run away, she should not be able to run after me and catch me. So this is the reason. This is a silly and humorous reason. He's saying that if I will be doing something wrong, I would be making mistake and I would be running. She should be fat enough that she won't be able to catch me. She won't be able to run after me. That's why I would get married to a fat woman. With such thoughts in my mind, I resumed my seat in the chair in front of the table. There were no more sounds from above. Earlier there were sounds of rats from the gable, but now there were no sounds. Suddenly there came a dull thud, as if a rubber tube had fallen to the ground. When he was admiring himself, when he was thinking about his marriage and what sort of girl or woman he wants, suddenly the rat's sound stopped and a thud sound. This is a thud when something falls on the table or the ground as if a rubber tube fell. This sound came. Surely nothing to worry about, but he did not bother to look at what it was. Even so, I thought I would turn around and take a look. No sooner had I turned than a fat snake wriggled over the back of the chair and landed on my shoulder. He could not even look back. To his greater surprise, a big fat cobra, a snake, black snake, was, you know, wriggled in a round shape. It was wriggling around his neck, fine. And wriggling actually means to move about. It was already moving about his from the back chair to his shoulder. The snake's landing on me and my turning were simultaneous, underlined. When he heard that thud sound, and he was thinking that I would turn and see what it was, the moment he turned back, the moment snake was there. Fine. I did not jump. I did not tremble. I did not cry out. There was no time to do any such thing. Why didn't he react? Because he was having no time to react even. The snake slithered along my shoulder. Slithered means sliding. Fine. So he was sliding along his shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow on this bicep, you can see. The snake was slithering, sliding, and making coils round shape around his arm. He could not even think that he would be admiring his beauty and he would be thinking about his marriage, and suddenly a snake would take rounds on his left arm. Beta, make sure you know which arm it was. Which arm it was? Left arm. You can get objective questions on anything, I'm telling you. Clear? So be vigilant, listeners. The snake slithered along my shoulder and coiled around my left arm above the elbow. The hood was spread out. This is the hood. He already spread his hood out and its head was hardly 3 or 4 inches away from my face. You can see 3 or 4 inches, this much difference. And what should a person do in such a condition? Obviously, nobody will be able to think even that if a snake is there and it has already taken rounds on the arm and spread its foot like this, near 3-4 inches away, and it can, you know, sting at any time. It would not be correct to say merely that I sat there holding my breath. So he was like statue. He was not moving. I was turned to stone. Means he was like a statue only now. But my mind was very active. Doctor is saying his mind was working. The door opened into darkness. The room was surrounded by darkness. In the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. Because there was no electricity in his room, there was darkness prevailing. The only light was coming from that lamp in front of that mirror. And he was sitting like a stone, not moving. Even he was just like an image in the flesh. I felt then the great presence of the creator of this world and this universe. I told you the theme of this chapter, that in the need of the hour, we remember God. In the need of the crisis, we miss God. Now, otherwise, he was thinking about a mustache, about his beauty, about how handsome he is, how more handsome he can look, and how he would be marrying a rich girl. And suddenly, when a snake appears, then, oh my God, universe is yours. God was there. Suppose I said something and he did not like it, I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, "Oh God." Means he was missing God that much now that he wanted to write this O-G-O-D. He wanted to write those letters, "Oh God." There was some pain in my left arm. Why? You know, when you're not moving your body, you are just statue at one place. You are just like a statue. There is game, na? Statue and over. You play that game, you will realize how difficult it is to remain at one pace without any movement. So he started feeling pain in his left arm because snake has wriggled around and coiled around. It was as if a thick leaden rod, no, a rod made of molten fire was slowly but powerfully crushing my arm. It's a cobra, come on. And cobra has a strength. The arm was beginning to be drained of all strength. What could I do? And force was being put up by that snake while sliding, while wriggling, while coiling around his arm. And he was not supposed to move. He was now getting tired of not moving. At my slightest movement, the snake would strike me. Fine. And he was knowing this thing that the moment, you know, I would try to move, this snake is going to sting. Death lurked 4 inches away. Underline this line. Very important. Lurked. Lurk mean to wait. Lurking. Waiting. Death lurked 4 inches away like this. So death was there in front of him. Suppose it struck, what was the medicine I had to take? Now he's thinking, if it struck me, which medicine I would be taking? There were no medicines in the room. I was but a poor, foolish and stupid doctor. I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. He, being a doctor, was thinking about which medicine he would take. You might have seen a video which was viral these days that a girl was there, you can say 7-year-old girl on social media. It was viral and she was going to switch on that button of a motor, and the moment she switched it on, a snake sting on the foot of that girl and she died. She did not die on the spot. She died gradually because nobody could know that she was, you know, stung by a poisonous creature, snake. She thought, you can say a casual thing happened to her, but she was not knowing the gravity of the situation. Even her family was not aware, and she died on the same day she got that sting because it is very poisonous. It seemed as if God appreciated that. The snake turned its head. The snake started turning its head now. It was 4 inches away. It started turning and he's thinking about God. It looked into, and you know, rather than looking at the author, that doctor or stinging it, it started looking into the mirror. Mirror was there on the opposite side of the doctor. He forgot his danger now. He was like, okay, fine, the snake has turned its head. It looked into the mirror and saw its reflection. The moment snake turned, there was a mirror in front of the snake. And as if a snake is looking into the mirror, I do not claim that it was the first snake that had ever looked into a mirror, but it was certain the snake was looking into the mirror. Was it admiring its own beauty? Was it trying? You can see this picture, beta. But that incident was like that. Half of the snake is on the arm of the doctor and half of the snake lurking there, looking in the mirror. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection to closer quarters. The mirror attracted the snake, and maybe he's thinking that, was it trying to make an important decision about growing the mustache or using eyeshadow and mascara or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead? So this is again funny. So that snake was got attracted towards this mirror, and snake again slithered from the arm to the table. Sorry. And it started looking into the mirror. And he was so happy, okay, this snake is now off my arm. And it is looking into the mirror. Fine. It is enjoying its reflection at closer quarters, as if it is making a decision about it will have a mustache, it will use eyeshadow, mascara, vermilion. What is a vermilion? Sindoor. The ladies wear that red spot, fine. And I did not know anything for certain what sex was the snake. Was it male or female? That's why he was not knowing whether it's a male or a female. That's why he's saying vermilion, mascara, or mustache. That's why it's a humorous narrative. I will never know for the snake unwound itself from my arm and slowly slithered into my lap. Dheere dheere, slowly, slowly, that came into his lap, and from his lap it crept onto the table and moved towards the mirror like this. So finally he could breathe. So that homeopathic doctor, he was relieved. Okay, God helped me finally. And from there it crept onto the table and moved towards the mirror. Perhaps it wanted to enjoy its reflection at closer quarters. Maybe it wanted to see his face from the closer section. I was no mere image cut in granite. So now he was not like a statue, not like a granite. I was suddenly a man of flesh and blood. Now he was able to move. Oh my God, finally. Otherwise, he was like a granite. Ek patthar ki tarah baitha tha. He was like a statue only. Fine. And now he could move. Still holding my breath, I got up from the chair. I quietly went out through the door into the veranda. Dheere dheere utha bhaga veranda mein, and from there I leapt onto the yard and ran with all his worth. Itni tez bhaga, usne piche hi nahi dekha. He means kept on running and running. He was so scared. He did not even have a second look at the snake. Phew. Each of us have the sigh of relief. Somebody asked. Now, this was the only incident narrated by the Dr. Beta. Now, there will be a number of questions posed by the listeners of this story. You know, a group of friends are sitting. Fine. And he's listening. All are listening. And now, everyone would be posing questions. Fine. Now, is it clear to everyone? Any doubts? Send me thumbs up quickly if the story is, so far is clear to you. Okay, most of you, Divya, Gagan, Dharya, Aryan, Karanveer, Raj. So it's clear to most of you. So I won't be sharing the, you can say, video with you today because we are not left with much time. Let's continue. Few, but what is a few means? It's an expression of disgust. Fine, when you feel something bad. So everyone have the sigh of relief who was listening to the story that finally he was relieved. So what were the list of questions now? Who's asking the question? The friends of this doctor. Then he asked, one of them asked, doctor, is your wife very fat? So this is humorous. So rather than asking how you saved your life, he's asking now, so you got married to a fat wife? No, the doctor said, God willed otherwise. Means it was God's wish. My life companion is a thin, reedy person. Underline the word reedy. Reedy means tall and thin. Tall and thin. He's saying my wife is tall and thin. With the gift of a sprinter. Who's a sprinter? The one who can run very fast. Fine. He says he wanted now that I would marry a fat woman who won't be able to run. So he got opposite of it. He got married to a thin and tall lady who was a very good runner. Someone else asked, doctor, when you ran, did the snake follow you? Second question asked by one of the friends. The doctor replied, I ran and ran till I reached a friend's house. It did not even look back. Immediately, I smeared oil all over myself and took a bath. But I ran like a madman. I did not even look back. And directly, I went to my friend's house. I applied. Smeared means spread. Applied. I applied oil all over my body. And I took a bath. I changed into fresh clothes. He borrowed clothes from his friend. Changed his dress. Next morning, at about 8:30, I took my friend and one or two others, two of his friends, to my room to move my things from there. But we found we had little to carry. Some thief had removed most of my things. When next morning he went back and he found most of his things were gone, a thief sneaked into his house because, you know, when he ran from his house, from his room, he did not lock his room. Firstly, because he was so scared from that snake. And everything was taken, stolen by a thief. Only one thing was left. What was that? Can you guess even? That pale vest. Joski vest thi. That was being hung over there only. The doctor said, my vest, the dirty one. The fellow had such a sense of cleanliness. Who the fellow? The thief. The rascal could have taken it and used it after washing it with soap and water. He's saying that that rascal, that man, that thief took everything from my room, whatever it was, a mirror, a comb, or a coat, or clothing, or a book. Only a vest was left. Tab wo bhi le jata. He should have washed and he should have worn it. Maybe he was a cleanliness freak. Did you see the snake the next day, doctor? Third question was asked by someone else. The doctor laughed. I have never seen it since. I have never seen it since. Means after that, I've never seen any snake. It was a snake which was taken with its own beauty. What does it mean? He's saying it was a snake which was attracted by its own beauty. And it went after looking into the mirror. It got attracted towards itself and it went away and it never came back. Now, what is the similarity between the snake and this doctor? When doctor was, praising himself, praising his own handsomeness, and he ran and he never came back. Similarly, the snake, when snake saw its beauty, it ran and it never came back. So that is a similarity. Both of them may be appreciating their own physical features and physical beauty. Clear? So we have read this chapter. Tomorrow, beta, I won't be giving a single answer to you. Fine? Because I have given detailed explanation along with word meanings, along with themes. Even I have answered many questions while teaching you. So you are the ones who would be speaking. Fine? And I would be showing you one video tomorrow. And after that, we will be doing question answers. Okay? So join Valentine. Have a nice day, beta.